what creates more soil in nature than anything else.
The grass is
No.
Water.
Huh?
Water.
Which water?
Systems.
Which water?
Marshes or?
Marshes.
I think.
Which marshes?
There are no marshes here.
No. No. But where, which marshes are you talking about? Where? Talking about planet. Where we're going? The most soil creation in nature on planet Earth.
Mangroves.
Right. Where are mangroves?
Tropics.
Tropics. Tropical estuaries. Shallow marine systems create more soil than anything else on the planet. Next, shallow lakes and ponds. One there. Mm. That's a shallow lake. It's a man-made one, but it's still a shallow lake. Then forests, then prairies, and then human home gardens. If you can't count them as being nature, but well, you have to get to a dilemma about are humans part of nature? And is gardening a natural activity? It looks like the garden, our home garden, is like the human nest. It doesn't appear in nature, it only appears with humans. It comes with us, you know. We collect lots of species and put them together as this sort of like small little human ecosystem called a garden. And we only need a garden to really survive. But if you don't have a garden, then you better get on the road. You're back to being a nomad. Because you don't stand a chance without a garden. You don't need a farm. You need a garden to survive. You can have a farm as well, but it's a larger garden, really. You have to farm like a gardener and garden like a farmer. But if you don't have the garden, then you're a farmer who doesn't eat his own food. Like we had saved the farmers in the drought, because the farmers don't grow their own food in Australia anymore. So when they have a drought and they lose money on the farm, they also have got no food to eat because they no longer are gardeners. You seem to have a lot of older people who are still gardening and growing their own food. That's not normal in a lot of the world, not modern world, like a lot of developed, overdeveloped world. So you're in a transition between the overdeveloped world and the underdeveloped world. You're in a sort of partially developed world with a bit of history hanging around. So that's good. That's great. Actually, that's really good, yeah. But soil creation, so by putting these things in, we would empty the dam every 50 years or so and pull out a load of incredibly good soil that's no good for your garden for about a year because it's anaerobic and it's like jelly. You pull it out, it's like a sloppy, sloppy thing that won't stay in one position. So you'd have to build a little catchment barrier and chuck it over the dam wall at the catchment barrier and it'll sit there like a wet jelly and dry out over about a year and then it'll be awesome, awesome garden soil. You can speed it up with compost tea if you want to.